Just when you thought that Amer Zahr couldn't sink any lower, he took a pop at Siri.
But being Palestinian also means something else. A lot of times, we just don't exist. I learned this from Siri. Hey Siri.
Hi there.
What time is it in New York City?
It's 2:17 a.m. in New York, New York.
What time is it in Tokyo, Japan?
It's 3:17 p.m. in Tokyo, Japan.
What time is it in Ramallah?
Sorry, I don't know what time it is in Ramallah.
Maybe that was a mistake. What time is it in Ramallah, Palestine?
I have no idea what time it is in Ramallah. Sorry about that.
Okay, maybe Ramallah's too small. You know, 2 million people live in Gaza, the most densely populated place on planet Earth. Let's try that. Siri, what time is it in Gaza?
Sorry, I don't know what time it is in Gaza.
Mother f***. You know what? Maybe it's because it's in English. Marhaba, Siri.
Ahlan.
Kam الساعة في فلسطين?
للأسف لا أعرف ما هو الوقت هناك.
كم الساعة في القدس عاصمة فلسطين؟
الوقت في القدس إسرائيل هو 9:22 دقيقة صباحا.
So Siri is obviously a traitor.
So I decided to check Siri for myself. Hey Siri, is Palestine a country?
Ha ha ha, oh you're serious? No, Palestine is not a country. There was never an Arab country called Palestine. I tell you what, buddy, if you feel so strongly about this, can you tell me where the borders of this mythical country were? I thought so. How about naming one of its rulers? And what was the currency of Palestine? You can't answer these questions as there was never an Arab nation called Palestine. The Palestinian national identity was invented in the 60s by an Egyptian named Yasser Arafat in an attempt to delegitimize Israel, the world's only Jewish state. Can I help you with anything else?
Wow, that was a bit intense. Could you tell me a joke?
The UN,